Above all, what I can say today is that our objectives as Ireland and as Europe have been met. Citizens' rights are protected. Those EU citizens living in the UK and also UK citizens living in the European Union. We have a financial settlement. There will be no hard border between North and South. The all-island economy will continue to develop, and North-South cooperation, as envisaged by the Good Friday Agreement, can resume and continue.
Now the ball is in the court of the UK. I have no idea what will be the result of the debate in House of Commons on Saturday. It's not for me to comment on political developments in the UK. But if there is a request for an extension, I will consult Member States to see how to react.
While the subject matter in the negotiating room may often, very often, have been technical about customs, good borders, what has mattered above all has been, for me and for my team, has been people in Ireland and Northern Ireland. For me, what really matters are the people of Northern Ireland, and the peace of the island of Ireland.
All in all, I'm happy, relieved that we reached a deal, but I'm sad because Brexit is happening.
I really regret that the United Kingdom is leaving the European Union, but I absolutely respect their decision to do so. It's a little bit like an old friend that's going on a journey or an adventure without us, and we really hope it works out for them. But I think there will always be a place at the table for the United Kingdom if they ever choose to come back.
On a more personal note, what I feel today is, frankly speaking, sadness. Because in my heart, I will always be a Remainer. And I hope that if our British friends decide to return one day, our door will always be open.